this video is promoting the swivel seat, but also I need to be a little real with everybody. I want some truths to be out there. So this video is going to be talking about the difficulty I went through on getting a swivel seat, which is really interesting. Hey guys, if you guys are new to my page, consider subscribing. What I do here is I live full-time in my van that I call Ghost. It is a Sprinter 144-inch wheelbase. I do vlogs like this about living van life. I've done it for 3 years now. I've also built two vans that I've lived out of, one on a very low budget, one on a higher budget, which I'm in now. It is my dream van. I did spend a little bit of money on it, but I'm happy. I was a performance artist, comedian for a little while. I have a degree in architectural engineering. I'm getting back into comedy in 2020, and I'm now consulting for van designs, who to get in contact with professional builders. I have a lot of contacts in this industry now. With the people that I know, I hope to guide people in certain directions that they want to go to. You can check all that out on my website, jaredtachi.com, or you can also get a hold of me on the Reachable app. That link will be in the description below. That is a great way to get in contact with me if you do not want a phone consultation and you just want a text and conversation. That's what the Reachable app provides. There's two links below. One is a trial period and one is my three packages. Take a look at both of them. Okay, so that's all good now. Here we go. This video is going to be hard for me because I don't like bad-mouthing anybody, especially publicly on a platform like this. But I also told myself when I started this page that I would be as real as possible. When I started this van build, that I would be as real and transparent as possible. I am going to kind of speak the truth here. I am going to say the company that I went through. I'm really going to just speak from my heart, and I hope you guys will understand that. I hope you guys will take it any which way you want. I hope that you will take whatever I say and make your own decisions. I'm not telling you to not go with the company that I went with, and I'm not telling you to go with the company I went with. I'm just going to tell you what the experiences I went through, as well as what they told me, and I felt a very disrespected. So we're gonna get into all that right now. So here we go. All right. So I guess pretty much let's start with the reasons on why I decided to do a swivel in the first place. I had a ProMaster the first go around. I actually should have put a swivel on that one, and I never did. But the swivel seat, or seats if you get both, is a wonderful way to kind of open up the space and kind of get extra room, you know, that you don't have as part of, you know, we only have 10 feet of cargo space. You know, having the swivel is such an amazing tool, and I only have one swivel, but if you can go with both, if you have the layout to do both, then why not, right? It's a wonderful space-saving tool, and it's amazing to have if you get it done, and if you design your layout that way. For example, my brother is doing this right now, that he has a family of four, him, his wife, and my niece and nephew. They are putting a bench seat here in the back, and their two front seats swivel, and they're gonna put a table in the middle, and that'll create a dining area. Swivels can come in handy in that way, if you design your van that way. So when I was designing my van, I had this in mind the entire time. You can see, I did a video on these guys already. This is Explore Outfitters. They're blackout window covers with magnets that go around the frame. Well, when I purchased these, I also purchased the ones behind me, which is my windshield and my side windows, all done through Explore Outfitters. And other companies do that, which I talked about in that video. I knew that this eventually was going to be its own space in itself. I did just check how well they do blackout, and they blacked out everything. It was great, actually. I can't say enough good things about it. You don't have to go through Explore Outfitters, but that link will be in the description below. You can watch that whole video because that'll explain a little bit more and why I like them, but their price point, I think, was amazing. You could make your own. It's just a pain. So this is kind of now another room inside. I can now be in a city, or I could be in a suburban area, or I could be out even in the wilderness. And not only do these black out, but they also help with temperature control. If anybody does live in a van now or is doing a van build, you'll know that the cab area, the temperature will fluctuate quite by a lot because of the amount of windows in here. It can either get hot really quickly, or it can also get cold at night really quickly, or cold in winter months. So having these up here also help quite a bit. They're white on the inside and they're black on the other, so it really just looks like a very dark tinted window when you look at it. I did think about making like an accordion style door right here that would actually just kind of tuck away behind my driver's seat. I did think about that. It might be in the future. It is kind of a pain to kind of build. Maybe down the road, I might consider doing something like that. We'll kind of cross that bridge when I kind of want to or need to. Right now, my curtain is working quite well, and I have no complaints with it. Plus, it's a lot cheaper. I've already spent enough on this van. All right, so that's really the reasons on why I went with a swivel in the first place. I also went with a swivel. Check out this picture. This picture was done. This is how I envisioned my van sitting in my van doing work one day, just like this picture where I have the bed down, I have the back doors open, my sliding doors open, I got the beach, I can do work at this table. That is how I envisioned everything when I designed my entire van and how I wanted it done. Plus, guys, I don't know about your vans, but these 2019 Mercedes seats, whew, they are super comfortable. Where did I get my swivel and why am I not a big fan of them right now? I will say the company name. I will not put the link in the description and you'll know why by the end of this video. I bought the swivel from Alpine Mechanics. We're going to kind of go through a time hop right now, okay? I'm recording this in December of 2019. My first phone call to Alpine was in the last week of July of 2019. So about 4 months went by between my first phone call and when I actually received the swivel. Also, not upset about that. About 4 months, maybe a little bit longer from my first phone call until I actually received my swivel seat from Alpine. If we go back to July, was finishing off the construction portion of the build and I was about to leave to go to Portland to finish the build. I left Boston on August 5th of 2019. I know for a fact I called Alpine before I left Boston. I know that. Before I left, I knew I wanted the swivel. I reached out to, I believe, Mercedes at the time, but they were on a pretty bad back order, or they were just non-existent on swivels unless you got them pre-installed in your van. So I put it out on Instagram to my following that who knows the best aftermarket swivel company. Three separate people commented or DM'd me and said Alpine Mechanics. I immediately called them the next day because it was late at night, so I called them the next day, and that was my very first phone call with them, the end of July. I asked them about their 2019 Sprinter swivels. Let's back up a little bit. The 2014 to 2018 Sprinters, they're all pretty much the same. 2019s are a different design when it comes to the seats and how the seatbelt is mounted, holes are drilled, everything. All that good jazz, right? Alpine was one of the first, if not the first, to have the 2019 swivels going to be in stock. I went on a bunch of different sites and Alpine said that they were out of stock, but they were going to get, they were getting an order in. So I called them and I said, hey, is there some sort of wait list? And they said, yes. At that moment, I put myself on the wait list. This is still the end of July. I asked them what number on the wait list I was. They told me I was number 18. They also told me they were getting 25 sets on their next order, and it was gonna be about 4 weeks, maybe six at the most, because they have to have a fabricator, they have to assemble them, and then they have to get them together and package them, and then they can ship them out. At this moment, I will also say, I am extremely happy with the product. Very happy with the product. As from what I understand from other swivels, other than the stock swivel, this one, it might even be better than the stock swivel, but I will say the product itself is unbelievable. So now I go to Portland. It's now end of August. I went to Descend on Bend. I was hoping to have my swivel seat before I went to Descend on Bend because it's a huge gathering of van lifers all across the board, whether they're large, small, doesn't matter. I was hoping to have my swivel in by then. It didn't happen that way. Oh well. After that, I actually was thinking to myself, hey, I haven't heard from them in a while. Let me call them and figure out what's going on. About mid-September. So it's about 6 weeks has passed since I called them the first time. So I get them on the phone. I said, okay, I was on the wait list for the Sprinter swivel seat. And also, by the way, I do want to say, because this is actually important later. Well, I told them I only wanted one. I told them I only wanted the passenger seat. I was on a wait list for a little while now, just kind of checking in and making sure everything is all good. And they said, oh yeah, we already got an order in and they're all gone already. Kind of shocked. And I was like, well, I was number 18 on the list. I thought you guys were getting a set of 25 in. And they said, yeah, we actually did. They did explain to me at this moment that people that were in front of me, 1 through 17, if they ordered more than one set, then that could be the reason on why I didn't get mine. Totally understandable at this point, right? I'm like, all right, cool. If you're an upfitter, you might have 2 or 3 Mercedes in your shop that you're doing swivels for. So you may have 2 or 3 orders. And if there's a few upfitters in front of me, guess what? They're going to take my number, my set away from me. And that's fine. They told me that that is possible. I'm totally okay with that. I get it. Still not upset. About a week goes by. This is when I start to get upset. And I'm at my friend's shop. He is actually not even a licensed upfitter. He is an upfitter, but not a licensed one. There is a 2019 Sprinter. Same exact van as mine. It is a 144. And it's sitting in his shop. I get into it. It's bare bones. There's nothing in there right now. He's working on the insulation. I'm kind of just checking it out. You know, having fun with my friend. And I see both seats are actually turned on a swivel. And I said, oh, did your client order that part of the package of the Sprinter? And he said, no. He said, those are Alpines. I said, well, that's interesting. I said, well, she was probably on the wait list before me. No big deal. So I asked him, I said, oh, when did she put that order in? He's like, yeah, she just called like 2 weeks ago, put herself on a wait list, and then she got the swivels like within 2 weeks, like beginning of September is when she called. Now, I've done customer service for probably 2 decades now. For me, when I do something wrong, I'm going to own up to it, especially with a consumer. I'm going to say, all right, I screwed up. I'm sorry. And I'm going to do everything I possibly can to make it better. Instead, I called them up and I said, hey, I'm actually with somebody right now that is an upfitter. They didn't put in the order. The customer put the order in and they have a set, and I'm with the customer and they told me that they put the order in at the beginning of September. I've been on the wait list a month before this person. And they said, well, we probably tried to call you and you didn't pick up your phone. And I'm like, that's impossible. Number one, you would have left me a message. Number two, you also had my email because they asked you for your phone number and your email. So then they lied to me. Not cool. If you were this other person that got swivels, they probably had no problems whatsoever, and they probably will tell you that the customer service was great. I'm just telling you what I went through. So at this moment, I was already on the wait list for the next sets to come in. The next sets were actually scheduled to come in the beginning of November. I did not want to piss them off to the point for me to get skipped over again. So I played it cool and I was like, okay, can you guys just please tell me when these swivels come in so I can get mine, please? At this moment, she's like, yup, and you can even call back and check in with us as much as you want. Okay, so now I'm calling twice a week until I get my swivel. I actually didn't even find out via phone call. I found out via Instagram they got their new swivels in. That was on a Sunday. I saw a post from that company saying new swivels are in, getting ready for shipping. So then I called on the Monday. I played stupid. I said, hey, any updates? And they said, yeah, actually, we just got them in. We're going to be packaging them, getting them together, assembling all that stuff. And I get that. I'm okay with that. We're going to be getting all that together and we should have something together by the end of the week. At this point, it's been about 3, almost 4 months. All right, again, you're the only people right now that have the swivels. Thursday comes around, I call back. I said, all right, is my shipment ready? I'm number 4 on the wait list. I should be getting there. 4 on the wait list. Thursday afternoon, when I did call and I said, all right, did you guys, is this happening now? They said, oh, we've already sent out 12 of the 25. I'm not a genius at math, but I'm pretty sure I know that 4 comes before 12. I said, all right, did I miss something? And she said, oh, if you're an upfitter, you can jump the line. I said, wait a minute, what? Yeah, well, upfitters get first of right. Therefore, if they're like number 20 or 25 and they want to jump in front of you, we give them priority. I'm like, are you kidding me? You already sent out 12 sets to however many upfitters? Oh, there's only like 4 upfitters, by the way, that ordered a whole bunch. I guarantee you they were just stockpiling them and they were not actually doing them in builds. Totally understand that. I'm wondering if the upfitters know that they jump over consumers. So then I asked the Alpine mechanics at this time. I said, well, you never disclosed that information. Again, as a consumer, I'm okay as long as there's a little bit of communication and there's some transparency telling me that upfitters are going to jump in front of me. And there's a chance that I actually might not be able to get my swivel when I wanted it. At this point, I've already been waiting 4 months and I want my damn swivel seat. No apologies. All they said was there's a little bit of a miscommunication. And they said, we should have yours out by the beginning of next week. I never told them that I was a YouTuber that does van build YouTube stuff. I never asked them for a discount. I never did anything of that nature, actually. I was willing to pay full price. I wanted to pay full price. Just a regular old customer. Because I'm not anybody. I am just like everybody else. So Monday comes around. I call them and I say, is there any more updates? They said, nope, it's not going to get in until... Your shipment's not going to be ready until tomorrow. At this point, I just gave up and I was like, whatever. I get a phone call Tuesday around 10 or 11 a.m., whatever it was. She said, your set is ready. And I said, set? No, I only want the passenger seat. I've actually told you this the very first time I called you and put you myself on a wait list. And then when I re-put myself on a new wait list, I said I only wanted the passenger seat. She then flipped out on me and said, we don't sell just one. We sell them only in sets. I said, okay, well, I only need the passenger. If need be, maybe I'll buy the driver as well. But I really don't want to spend the extra $500 because, by the way, these cost $500 a piece. They're not cheap. By the way, there's also $150 in shipping. But, and also, I didn't even know I paid that shipping price until after the fact. Whatever. So at this point, they were like, there's nothing we can do for you. We can't give you a passenger by itself. At this point, blowing steam out of my ears, I didn't like the fact that they were not transparent. There was a lot of miscommunication. I was never told that I needed to buy a set. I was never told that upfitters can actually jump the line. I was totally skipped over and lied to the first go around, and that was obvious, and I proved it. After they got off the phone with me at that point and they said there's not going to be a passenger all by itself, I actually called three of my upfitter friends and I said, can you please call Alpine Mechanics and can you order a passenger swivel seat for me, and I will come into you and I will pick it up, or I will pay for the shipping to where I am. Pretty much all the responses were laughing because they had no idea that they were jumping lines. And I get it. You know, upfitters have their repeat customers. I get it. But guys, we're still consumers. Is that really how you want to treat your customer? Yeah, I understand this is like a video Yelp review, but I mean, come on. So about 15 minutes goes by and I get a phone call from Alpine Mechanics and they suddenly had a passenger seat available for a single unit to purchase. I have no idea if one of my upfitter friends actually called them. I have no idea if they looked me up on YouTube. I don't really care because I just wanted my damn swivel at the end of the day. Yeah, it was really annoying. They email you installation process, and the installation is actually extremely easy. You just make sure you have to disconnect the battery, and they even tell you how to do that during the instructions. And as you can see, I put one of the Lagoon mounts right here. I wanted to do that so I could have this table here. So anybody can do that, by the way. All you have to do is mark the holes, drill them, and then you can kind of mount the Lagoon mount there. Anybody wants to take that idea, take it. It's actually really, really just convenient, by the way, to do it this way. I mean, you could also put the Lagoon, like if you had a wall over here like I do, you could put it on the wall over here. I also put an outlet underneath my seat for my laptop so I can charge my laptop. I don't have to like run a cord to my other things. So really, I just wanted to make this video to kind of, you know, make sure everybody knows what's going on. I will try and put some links below to other swivel seat companies. I've also heard other horror stories about some other swivel seat companies. Again, I will say, the product itself is remarkably unbelievable. I really like how it operates. I really like how it swivels. I love how they emailed the instructions. I was just really, really turned off by how bad their customer service was. I think I only spoke to really one person. So I hope that that person watches this video and understands, you know, really what's going on. You know, if they want, I am available by email and I'm more than happy to talk about the problems that I had. I did pay full price. I don't care. I'm not looking for a rebate. I'm not looking for a refund. I don't want any of that. I just want it known to everybody out there that, hey, if you're on a wait list, there's a good chance that you're going to be passed over because upfitters get first. I'm just totally, you know, unless you have an upfitter friend that could make a phone call for you. Like I said, I was just totally turned off by how they were, treated me as a customer. I did still use the product. I don't know if I would use them again in another build, I'll tell you that right now. I'm gonna be doing some festivals relatively soon, so check all that out, yada yada yada, all that good jazz, and I'll see you guys next time. Later!